so it begins.
That's right, and so it begins. Every year around the second or third week in April, Dave and I get together at his place in Poughkeepsie, New York to begin prepping my Nissan Xterra for our upcoming storm chase trip. The first thing we usually do is mount the windshield hail guard.
Please.
Oh, yeah.
No, it looks like it's going to clear it.
Oh, it's close.
It is.
Let's see. What's it hanging up on? There we go.
All right.
Okay. What do we got next? We got other guards that need to go on. Dave putting on one of the bolts for the cargo area guard. We don't use two U-bolts for this because one is plenty sufficient. It is not going anywhere.
You know, for the Discovery Channel peeps, I have a Discovery Channel thermometer and dew point sensor.
Yeah, all right, it's not the, you know, Davis Weather Monitor 2,
yep,
which I have at home, but it gives us, you know, some quick temperature dew point readings while we're out on the road.
These are the passenger guard. Passenger side hail guard, and basically they're held on with clips, which are right here and right over here, and they clip onto the edges of the door, and they enable this thing to swing up and down so that we can actually swing the guard out of the way when we're not using it, or if we need to, you know, talk to somebody outside the window.
Yeah, we didn't want something that was in the deployed stage all the time.
Yeah.
Not at least for these windows.
Then you can't talk to the cops who pull you over.
Right, exactly. They knock on your window and you go, it's already down.
It's like, here's another ticket for you. They're held in either position by these large magnets, which are about 50 to 60 pounds of pull each. And so they'll lock onto the bottom when it's down, and they lock onto the top when it's up.
There's your driver one, deployed. We don't worry about the glass when we don't need it. There you go.
So this is our dome / roof camera from last year. Basically, it's a GoPro camera, HD camera that's in an acrylic dome here. It's got attached to a pan tilt unit. So basically we can move the camera around remotely. And we can also record directly on the camera and can feed that video back to a display inside the car so that we know where to point it. This is actually the control box, which is getting more complicated by the day. I keep adding stuff to it, but basically it's inside. It's basically an LCD television that serves as a monitor, and it's got a bunch of switches and power regulators and supplies in there that will power the camera and its various features.
And that is inside the vehicle with us, so we can control everything.
And we've got a long umbilical cord that goes out to the top of the roof of the car. So when you turn it on, you basically have controls over turning the camera on, which we'll do in a second. There it goes. And I can turn on the TV. And basically I'm seeing what the camera is seeing, even though I don't have a card in there. I have my controls here to turn the pan tilt zoom, or pan tilt, so I can go that way and that way.
There we go.
So I can do whatever I want with the camera. Now that was all designed last year. The new thing for this year is going to be this. This is not completed yet, but it's going to be a wiper system, which was partially designed for me by Brad over in Mesodome. The water, you know, on the side where the wind is hitting is not a problem. But on the back side, it collects over here, and once you try and view through that, it looks really bad. It's a terrible video. And most of the time, we're going to want to view out of the back, so we want to be able to clear that water off. I've got it all wired in here, and it'll spin a wiper around like that.
Right on top of the dome.
And it'll wipe the water off the dome.
Sweet.
Now, after we got together, Dave had his work cut out for him. He had to make several modifications to the wiper assembly to ensure that it would work with our specific dome. After some cutting, sawing, and drilling, we're now good to go.
There is the cell phone antenna, and this is basically an antenna that will boost our cell phone signal. We've used it the last couple years. It is awesome. Excellent. Yeah. And then here, there's our, down there is the power strip. We're gonna be hooking up the XM. Yes, the XM ThreatNet, which we don't really use. We mainly use GR level 3, but it's a backup. And for those data holes like in Northwest Oklahoma, the ThreatNet sure comes in handy, so.
Well, I'm pretty pleased that at least we got these preparations out of the way. It's always a pain to put these big guards on, like when we're on the road already, because it cuts down time from chasing, and you don't want to be late to a target area because of these things. So we did the hard parts already. Now all we have to do is get on the road and head out.
All right, so we basically have completed our Chase 2012 preps here today up at Dave's house in Poughkeepsie, New York. It's April 20th. And we got our Lexan guards on, most of them anyway. The rear door guards and the back window guard will leave off till the day we leave. They go on pretty quickly. We got everything wired up the way we want it. And we're looking forward to getting out there and doing some chasing. Being so far from Tornado Alley, we can't really just shoot out there and shoot back. Some of the folks that live out there, you're definitely lucky in that aspect that you could chase a lot more than we can. We're looking forward to getting out there as soon as we can. It looks like right now, with this being the end of April, it could be as little as 2 weeks that we'll be hitting the road. So we're looking forward to it, getting out there and doing some chasing. I think we'll be getting together again shortly. Now is the drive back to New York City.
Yep. See you either in a few days or a few weeks.
One way or another. And then we'll be spending an awful lot of time in this car. Later.
See ya.